Life's too short to drive boring cars. There's lots of reputations about BMWs not being reliable. And while I'm the first one to admit that there are certain unreliable models, not every one of them is as bad as a lot of people suggest. I have some theories, and I'm going to share that with you today. Ultimately, why is it that BMW is not able to maintain a level of reliability that you're finding in a Lexus or even an Acura for that matter? Why is it that BMW struggles with oil-burning V8 engines, oil leaks, and valve cover leaks, and electronic failures? Why are these problems still existing in this time and place? I mean, BMW has been doing this for a long time, and at some level, you'd think they'd learn from some of the mistakes. I mean, you never get it right the first time, but at the end of the day, they continue to make the same mistakes time and time again, and it begs the question, why? Why are they making the mistakes that we see them to continue to make? And while sometimes they make corrections along the way, often the same problem continues over generation, and we're stuck with vehicles that, yes, they're a blast to drive, and ultimately that's why we drive them, but it still begs the question, why are we having to drive vehicles and compromise reliability for the sake of performance? So I'm going to dive into the whole conversation and share with you guys today why I believe BMW is not able to match the reliability of what you're finding in a Lexus. Let's get into it now. So first, let's investigate case number one. What we have here is a BMW X6. Now, the X6 has been very, very popular ever since come out. Not everybody wanted that high-top SUV, and the X6 is able to give you that shaved-off look that a lot of people are looking for in a sport crossover. Right here, we have the 35i, and that means it's got the outgoing N55 engine, which is a single turbo but twin scroll tucked under the hood there, and it's an inline six-cylinder engine. But before we get to that, I mean, look, we've got some great touches. I love that two-tone, and of course, they've got some great vents there, and this awesome little running board. And how about the wheels? Really, BMW makes some of the nicest wheels on the factory vehicles. Of course, they've got these great little squashed version of a Hofmeister's Kink. And of course, there you've got lots of glass on top to allow for the sun in for all the little hooligans riding around in there. Of course, BMW right there and their classic angel eye headlights. And there you have your standard grille that you're finding in virtually every BMW today. Here, of course, you get a very stylish style of grille with a wonderful profile. And the interior is still slightly conservative, but high quality, and they typically wear very, very well. Of course, we've got keyless entry there as well in the back. And here we have the X6, as mentioned. And we have one and two tailpipes on the X6 with the turbo six-cylinder engine. But look, we have already wear and tear going on this plastic trim that we're finding right here. And I mean, what are the reliability of these? Well, it's a six-cylinder, three-liter turbo. And as I mentioned, it's the N55, which is actually a lot better than the outgoing engine. So if you hearken this back to the N54, when BMW introduced back in 2006, they came out with the N54, which was their first attempt at turbocharging one of their six-cylinder engines. And it was twin turbos, and unfortunately, it had a lot of problems, from wastegate rattle to high-pressure fuel pump issues to injector leak downs. There was even bulletins where they were committing to have to replace the fuel injectors under warranty and extended warranty because they were failing excessively. Lots of oil leaks, and although the internals were strong and they were forged, the foundation of the engine was good. Unfortunately, it was a lot of the garbage around it that tended to fail. But what about this one?
Well, they've eliminated one of the turbos. The turbocharger issues are reduced. Wastegate rattle is reduced.
There's still high pressure fuel pump related issues from time to time.
But this engine has been slightly dialed in, and it is far more reliable than the outgoing N54. So in a case like this, BMW learned quickly after that first generation of the N54 that it was time to move on and do something more efficient and more reliable. And here you go, you have this engine. And moving from the N55, we go to the current generation. Here's an X5. It has the current generation B58 engine, which is also a 3-liter turbocharged twin scroll. It's seen vast improvements throughout. Now, while this engine sees more boost and outputs more power, BMW took more note of the cooling and the fuel injection systems and made this engine far more reliable. As a matter of fact, the engine under this hood is the same engine
that they're using in the Toyota Supra. You've got to believe if Toyota's putting their stamp of approval on it, it's got to have some durability incorporated.
But here's a current X5. Let's take a look. Obviously, the grille's slightly different. Larger and more in charge right now in the current generation X5 right here. Of course, you've got lots of piano gloss black, and you've got those great LED lights. They are laser, and there were actually recalls because they were emitting blue luminescence that were actually blinding to oncoming traffic, but that is a recall and it's being taken care of. They also have great wheels on this generation, and this little vent to again identify that it's something unique from the lesser models. Of course, we've got the updated handles with keyless front and back, and You've got the big glass panel on top with this large luggage rack to haul more garbage to the dump, and a revised taillight system, which is far nicer than what you'll finding on that generation. These ones are nicer, more improved, and LED in this great little X5. And you'll notice you've got these different style of exhaust tips. They're more incorporated now than they were on the old ones where they protruded. Here you actually got them way down deep embedded in there. And as I said, it's X drive, so it's all wheel drive, and it's the 40i. Now, as I say, there's numerous straight six engines that BMW's built over the years. They've always been more reliable in naturally aspirated format. In other words, without turbos. They introduced turbocharging. The N54 was a disaster for reliability. Then the N55 was slightly better, and the B58 seems to be better yet. More boost, more power, more efficiency, and more reliability. So it seems like BMW learned their lesson here. Then BMW comes along with a four-cylinder engine. They've always manufactured four-cylinder engines for a lot of their vehicles, from the cars to the SUVs, and we have that in many of the models. For example, this X3 behind me here. And taking a look, we have this great headlight assembly. You'll notice it's slightly dialed down from the X5, but it's also, there you go, BMW LED. And they have some beautiful wheels on this modern-day BMW with their own unique style of vent and a rocker panel that has its own level of refinement. Hofmeister. Sunroof, interesting mirrors, and a hood that just speaks volumes for powerhouse. But you'll notice it's got the larger grille as well on this newer generation, and this little intake vent. They're doing a lot with the vents. And going along the side, it's a beautiful design. There's lots of contours along the side of these. They have vastly improved from the older generation vehicles. Here we've got LED taillights in these as well. And you'll notice one and two chrome exhaust tips again. Inside is the actual magic. The outside is more just a clean finish. But this is the X drive, and it's a 30i. That means it's a 2-liter four-cylinder turbocharged engine. And in these vehicles, they produce about 255 horsepower. Now, so far, the B48, which this is, seems to be far more dependable than the outgoing engine. Why? Well, the N20 was the engine that you got in these cars before the B48. And the N20 had lots of issues, from sucking up oil filters to the infamous timing chain rattle and catastrophic failure. So BMW seems to have learned a little bit about improving on their engines in both the 4 and the 6-cylinder guises. And then BMW's also dabbled with V8 engines, where they've seen a lot of challenges over the years. For example, what we have here is an X5, but equipped now with the V8. It's called the N63, and it's gone through numerous upgrades. Why? Because the first generation of the N63 were disastrously unreliable. Lots of problems with timing chain rattle and failure, fuel injectors leaking down, lots of problems related to battery drain. But the big problem with the N63, particularly in the earlier models, was because it's a hot V. And there's two turbos, and they're mounted in the V of the engine, and they sit there and they get very, very hot, especially when you're driving hard. Well, it's all that heat that was building on top of the engine within the V of the engine, creating hot spots and leading to earlier deterioration of valve guide seals. Valve guides would wreak havoc as well as on plastics and wiring that were all mounted on top of the engine, resulting in a lot of failures and heavy oil consumption. Unfortunately, throw a bunch of plastic under the hood and that just exacerbates the whole issue, and you have a recipe for utter and ridiculous disaster. Now, while the N63 is getting better every generation, unfortunately, it continues on to be an issue. You talk to the owner of any BMW that has that 4.4-liter twin-turbo V8 under the hood, guaranteed they're going to comment about high oil consumption. That's always a thing, on top of all the failures that they typically find with these vehicles. Now, it does show that BMW has taken care, and the latest generations are getting better and better with time. And up till this day and age, any luxury brand that did not have a V8 available for some of their premium cars wasn't really considered a true luxury brand with any credibility, i.e. Mercedes with their V8s and twin turbo V8s, BMW with their V8s. You've got to have a V8 available to satisfy that marketplace. Now, sadly, BMW didn't quite learn with the V10 that they had the S85 that they put in the M5 and the M6. That was one of the most wonderful engines from a driver's perspective. Unfortunately, they never quite got it right, and rod bearings were the issues in those, as well as throttle actuators, SMG pump problems, and electronic rear differentials that would blow out.
By the time they figured out it was a lost cause, they changed the whole model and brought in the F10 M5 to replace the outgoing E60 M5 because they knew it was a lost cause. So what are some of the other reputational issues that BMW has? Well, let's share a few.
A lot of times BMW is using a lot of plastic under the hood. Why? For weight savings, for performance, for the environment to save and being able to use and reuse a lot of the products that we use today.
So they can get repurposed time and time again over many generations. So the marketing aspect is BMW does it for the sake of the environment. But let's talk about a few things.
Oil pan issues, we've got leaks there, which a lot of vehicles get that. Valve cover leaks, of course, with a lot of the valve covers nowadays, you have the valve cover and you have a rubberized style of gasket, which gets hard, brittle, because of a lot of the modern engines now have turbocharging. For example, right in here, we have turbos. Now, while this is the B58, typically any of the turbo engines emit enough heat that it starts to break down the gasket and it winds up with a top end leak. Other problems you'll find with the oil filter housing gasket. On the six cylinder engines, usually it's mounted right here on the driver's side. There's a housing. It's got a cooler that runs through it. And it's that housing that often starts to leak at the base or it creates mixing problems with antifreeze and oil.
And the funny thing is, everybody knows that the oil filter housing gasket is a problem. Then why is it that my old N54 powered 335 back from 2007 has that housing? And now I looked under the hood of a very modern BMW M4 and it has virtually the same identical oil filter housing setup. It tells me that they know about it, but they don't care. Why? Because in my opinion, a lot of it has to do to satisfy the service side of the business. And if they built everything bulletproof, that would hurt their business unit. So then what is it about Lexus that makes them so reliable versus a BMW? Well, number one, that 3.5 liter V6 has been around forever. It's naturally aspirated. They don't have that excessive heat under the hood that you find with a lot of BMWs. Even though the cars are typically slightly less powerful, they stick with what they know. And if there's a problem, they work it out and they continue down that path and reuse that same engine over and over and over again. Same thing, 5 liter V8. Although there's some issues with a little bit of coolant starting to leak and winding it puddling in the V of the engine, for the most part, the 5 liter V8 is a bulletproof piece as well. And Lexus 4-cylinder engines are often equally reliable. Now they're dabbling with turbocharging, time will tell. But generally speaking, Lexus keeps it simple for the sake of pride and construction and not be too hasty in making quick changes to their designs. So to be quite honest, this is a real love-hate conversation because we love BMWs for the way they drive. When you start the engines, they're smooth, they settle out to an easy idle, they drive nice, they're tight, and they perform like really no other car out there. So if you want the best driving experience, BMW is where it's at. Some of that comes with lightweight materials. Unfortunately, we pay the price when things break. And some of it comes with innovation. And they're always pushing the boundaries. So they're seeking ways to make their cars perform better, more efficient, drive better, quicker shifting, more power. And it's those innovations and changes that are all about blazing trails. And unfortunately, sometimes blazing a trail means you've got to carve out some tough bush. And that's where Lexus starts to fall behind. They keep it clean, they keep it simple. And while a lot of people love that business model, if you're looking for the best driving experience, you're likely going to find it in a BMW. And unfortunately, reliable sometimes takes a back seat to innovation. And with all of that said, be sure to click right there. You're going to find the most reliable luxury cars on the market today. Hope to see you real soon. Catch you then. Bye-bye.